Cassandra Hill in Ashtabula. Their law group staff, oh my God, they are amazing. They went out of their way with the first accident to come to the facilities where my friend Eli was at, where I was at with him, because I did not leave his side, and to get all the paperwork for both Eli and me all taken care of and everything, they came to where we were. Excellent. Every call I made to the office was answered in a timely manner. And, I mean, normally whenever I called in, I'd tell them who I was, oh, just a minute, and they'd get somebody right on the line. I never had a bit of problem. Jennifer is the one that came to Regency, and I mean, tremendous. And Jackie, every time I called, she's the one that mainly got all my calls. Vince, and oh, there was other departments too that I had to talk with as it went through the different channels. You wouldn't believe how much is involved in a case, and don't try to handle it yourself. Well, the first accident, we were sitting out on the road to make a left-hand turn into my driveway, and I looked in my rearview mirror and saw this car coming down the road, and I knew that it was going way too fast, and boom, it hit us. I had bruising, neck injuries. I had to go through physical therapy. And the second one, wow. That's a pretty involved one. We were pedestrians standing, watching a live nativity, when this girl pulled into the side of a truck, and the truck lost control and come up over the curb and plowed into four of us that were standing there in a group. I didn't actually see it coming. I was taking pictures with my cell phone, and I saw the light. I mean, I heard the crash, and our friend that lives with us was standing next to us, Dwight, and he said, "Holy hell," because he had seen it, and I'm thinking to myself, you know where we are, we're at a church nativity. And at that point was when I saw the light on my camera, but I didn't put two and two together. The next thing I knew, I was flying through the air. I felt this hit on the back of me, and I was flying, and I don't know. I didn't feel myself when I hit the ground when I came down. But I immediately looked, and I saw my brother, who was at the pole, and I went to him, but they wouldn't let me near him. And then I happened to see another friend of ours, Eli, who also lives with us, who was about 60 feet the east side of my brother, and went to him, and it was pretty bad. He was laying there unresponsive, blood coming out of his nose and mouth, and I really thought he was dead. In that second accident, it was a few days before I went downstairs to the emergency room at Metro, where Eli was at. My brother had died the night of the accident at Metro, going into surgery. They took me down to CAT scan and everything like that. At that time, they told me they didn't find anything. But since then, I'm getting ready to go into surgery for the problems with my neck. I have it's C3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. They're going to go in and decompress and put in rods and pins and bone grafts. The first one, it settled. Mm-hmm. With the second one, there was a lawsuit. It also went from Chester's office to another attorney who handles the suit part. Extremely wonderful people. I mean, I don't think that the Chester Law Group could have connected up with anybody else any better, because, I mean, tremendous. I called, and same thing there. I called, and I would get a hold of somebody, and if I didn't get somebody right then, you know, they got right back to me. They're wonderful. Use them. Be sure you don't try try to do this on your own. There is so much involved.